Hello and welcome to this panel discussion on eliminating the gender pay gap. I'm Annette Young, the host and creator of The 51%, a show on France 24 English about women reshaping our world. Now, as the pandemic continues to take its toll on the global economy, 5% of all employed women have apparently lost their jobs. This compares to some 3.9% of working men. However, this global economic crisis also means that the time it's going to take to close that gender pay gap has increased from 100 years to 136 years, all just in a space of 12 months. Joining me is Sébastien Bazin, the CEO of HeForShe, and Jean-Pascal Tricoire, the chairman and CEO of Schneider Electric. And they're going to be talking about the steps that their respective companies have taken in order to close the gender pay gap. So why are you particularly committed to gender equality, and why should other CEOs do the same? Let me start by asking you, Sébastien.
I've been saying it for a long, long time. I don't see any one good single reason for paying a female less than a male for the same job. I don't see one. So since we don't see any, just go for it and just make sure that, I guess, you give them the same amount of pay for the similar job. So, and it's doable. Act upon it, have the right methodology, implement it, be proud about it, and embark the man. The one mistake not to do is to only act with a woman without basically convincing the man that it's also for their own good.
Let me now ask the same question to Jean-Pascal. Why are you particularly committed to gender equality, and what would you say to other CEOs?
Yeah, well, I would endorse what Sébastien just said, the right thing to do. So moral, right thing to do. Of course, the society is gender balanced, so our companies must be gender balanced. And I would go, it's a strong business case also. More and more of our customers are women, of course. And the balance also bring a lot of more innovation and creativity in the way we work together. So from the business point of view, it makes the company much better. If you, like we do at Schneider, believe that great people make a great company, having access to all the talent pool, all whatever the gender, it's absolutely an obligation.
Sébastien, let me start with you. Why do you think the gender pay gap remains still such an issue for many organizations? And when you take into account, we're 21 years already into the 21st century.
I think it starts from the top. If the leader of a company wants to endorse that cause, as they all should, then it's only a matter of shouting it and again, explaining why you want to do it. But no, it's only a question of make it the commitment, and then there's no excuse not to do it. Absolutely no single excuse.
Jean-Pascal?
I would confirm it starts with a strong conviction from the leadership level. But at the same time, if you want to succeed, and Sébastien said it before, you have to embark everybody in the company into it, and starting with the men. Because, of course, if you have to operate a transition, that means you are coming from male-dominated environment, and they are the main agents of change. In our case, it meant putting together a whole training of everybody in the company to educate people about the bias on the misconceptions that we can have in the company on gender differences, on impact of gender in the way we judge and assess people. All of this is absolutely feasible, and it starts first by squaring your HR system, which anyway would be necessary, defining then what a pay gap is, making sure that people, as I said before, are educated to bias, misconception, and are embarked on correcting that.
Sébastien, how does addressing the gender pay gap change the organizational structure?
The most difficult thing to do, as I told you, is you can pay people the same, but do you give them the same authority, the same empowerment, and the same chances in life? It has to do with having your high potential being identified, having diversity inclusion within that measurement, and making sure that, I guess, you take them on your back and you offer them both mobility or accountability and empowerment, the same chances. So that's much more soft, non-quantifiable, and much more difficult to do.
Jean-Pascal, do you have anything to add to that question?
I would really say it's equity of opportunity, because again, salary gaps, you address it, it's addressed at Schneider, but making sure that you give the same amount, the same equity of opportunities to women and to men. And to be very clear, in the situation where we started from, we needed clearly to accelerate women opportunity, because somewhere the past had been penalizing women on their career progression, and we had them, some of them, or many of them, to catch up, and therefore to accelerate their career path so that they would accumulate enough experience and accelerate the kind of catch-up they were deserving into their representation at the top of the company.
Sébastien, going forward, ACOR has joined Generation Equality as an action coalition leader. What does this mean for you, and what do you hope to achieve?
One out of three women on this planet have been facing sexism or sexual harassment. That same number for the hospitality sector is above 80%. So far more than a third. And I am in despair when I actually understand that number. Either they've been victim of it, or they've been witnessing it. We cannot continue that way. So just again, as we have done for equal pay, just make sure you're part of a coalition, make sure you can be a leader in that coalition, because that forces me to act, and make sure you really tackle the three, which is sexism, which is sexual harassment, and domestic violence.
At this point, I'm going to have to leave it there. I'd like to thank both of you, Sébastien Bazin from ACOR, Jean-Pascal Tricoire from Schneider Electric. Thank you.